Wi-Fi channel, which is a basic channel available on cable, their core audience is actually 34 to 54 years old. And for their Saturday night, lineup, they've actually chosen to create an all horror movie film fest, basically. FearNet, which is a popular website that's been serving horror movies, is also creating a basic channel called FearNet. And they found that their audience actually comprises mostly of women. So interestingly enough, women under 25 and over 25 are just as likely to see horror films as men under 25. Some of our case studies for horror comedies, Shaun of the Dead. With a $5 million budget, it made $16 million in the domestic box office, in the international box office. The Host, with a $12 million budget, made $87 million worldwide, $2.2 million because it's in limited release. And despite the seriousness of their faces, this actually is a slapstick comedy. I had no idea that Koreans could be funny, but they can. And of course, this is not a horror comedy, but I wanted to show you Paranormal Activity with a budget, yes, of $15,000. It made an international box office gross of $108 million, domestic box office of $86 million. You don't really have to go into this, but you know, we can talk about it later if you like. And then here are our income projections. Basically, the way we put these projections together is to take the worldwide, take the percentages of income from Adams Media Research from 2006. And as you can see, just income from the box office receipts alone, which only account for about 24%, you can actually make an incredible return by investing in a film like Brain Damage. At this point, though, I will take some questions.
Distribution plan, what are you thinking?
Well, first we want to hit genre film festivals. One of the most important ones actually is Fantastic Fest in Austin. It was founded by Tim Lee and Harry Knowles, and they've actually been very successful. They've had national attention, and lots of acquisition executives are showing up for this particular kind of film. Other distribution avenues, of course, will be DVD, and we are also going to approach Sci-Fi and FearNet. FearNet not only has a cable channel, but it also has an internet platform as well for delivery.
Questions?
Yes, Paul.
Yeah, I'd like to hear more about your protagonist and his conflict.
Rufus is the main protagonist. He's from a family of plumbers, but he actually went to a very expensive Eastern college and got a very expensive degree in English literature. And he doesn't want to be a plumber, but he finds himself in a situation where the job is not just about plumbing anymore. So as far as his character arc goes, he goes from somebody who doesn't want to work for the family business, he's lazy, he's, you know, thinks he's above it all, to somebody who actually ends up saving the day by partnering with the very people that he used to look down upon.
What's the budget right now?
The budget currently is $824,000. Yes.
Why do you think that people are going to be interested to see another movie about creatures?
About creatures? Well, and actually it's interesting that you say that, because the genre actually calls films like these creature features. And I think that people will be interested because they always have been. Horror films have always been the bread and butter of many studios. For instance, Universal, they made a lot of money off of the B-horror movies, which America became famous for. But also New Line Cinemas, some of their bread and butter is actually horror films like Nightmare on Elm Street. You don't see it stopping. And even with the phenomenon of Blair Witch, people thought something like that could never happen again. And yet Paranormal Activity came just a decade later and basically eclipsed Blair Witch as well. There's always been an audience for horror films. My theory about why it's not just men under 25 is that you can grow older, but you can stay immature for as long as you like.
So $824,000, talk a little bit about casting and about special effects.
Okay. For casting, we are actually asking for a modified low-budget contract from SAG. Actually, with horror films, one of the beautiful things about horror films is that you don't necessarily need a star. in order to attract people to watch it. The film itself is of interest. And as far as special effects, we've limited special effects. We've limited our special effects because basically the storyline does not require you to actually spend, you know, 40 minutes really conversing with one of the worms or, you know, having to understand their, you know, basic philosophy. So we have we've divided special effects budget between live special effects and CGI. We found a local CGI company that was able to create special effects just in spots where we would need it. And then we will be using mechanical special effects that are using the traditional plaster, rubber molding and casting process. And those effects sometimes can look a little bit cheesy, but that was actually used in Ridley Scott's Alien, when you see the birth of the new alien. That was actually a rubberized mold that was just basically a puppet. That was before the time of CGI. And we believe that our budget will work